हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ निनाद पंडित। आई एम द फैकल्टी एट सावरकर आई स्टडी सर्कल एंड आई विल बी कंडक्टिंग योर इकोनॉमिक्स मॉड्यूल विद रिस्पेक्ट टू यूपीएससी। फॉर पीपल हु आर स्टडिंग फॉर वेरियस अदर एग्जामिनेशन सच एज एसएससी, एनडीए, सीडीएस, दे ऑल्सो कैन रेफर टू दिस यूपीएससी मॉड्यूल बिकॉज यूपीएससी जनरली हैव अ वास्ट सिलेबस। ऑलराइट, सो वंस यू स्टडी विद रिस्पेक्ट टू यूपीएससी, अदर एग्जामिनेशन बिकम केक वॉक फॉर यू। So, we'll be dealing with the economics module, generally 25 to 30 sessions, and we'll try to cover all parts, okay? So, whenever I start my lecture, I try to give you the index, because once you know the index, it becomes easy for you to understand what is the syllabus we're gonna cover. Let me tell you one more thing, I have created my index based on the indexes of various books related to economics. So, if you don't find this index useful, you can create your own index as well. You can modify my index, you can add various other chapters to this index. So, it's completely based on you. Alright. So, as you can see on your screen, there are total 8 chapters. The first chapter will be the introduction part. In introduction part, we'll be dealing with the evolution of economics as a separate subject. How money is evolved, what do you mean by money, and why do we relating currencies to dollar. All these parts will be covering in introduction session. Then we have crisis, world crisis or the Indian crisis, which are dealing with the meaning of money. For example, 1928 Great Depression, South Asian crisis gave us a broader look about what do we mean by money. Then the third chapter will be types of economies such as state economy, capitalistic economy and mixed economy. And also one more important classification in economics, that is macroeconomics and microeconomics. So fourth and fifth chapter will be dealing with macro and micro. I have added Indian and world economics in macro and micro itself. Generally people study it separately, but I feel it comfortable, or I find it easy to understand when they study macroeconomics, will be dealing with the world economics with respect to macro and Indian economics with respect to macro, again with the same in the microeconomics. Okay, so we will not be studying world economics and Indian economics separate subject or a separate chapter. Then the next next chapter will be the stock market, which is a very interesting chapter. Many of you might be having various questions with related to this. And then we have the banking sector. After banking sector, we'll be dealing with the organizations, world organizations, which are very important factor for regulating various economies across the world. So let's start with our first chapter, that is the introduction part. First, we need to understand the meaning of these two words, that is economics and economy. Generally, we find these two words similar, but they have a very minute difference. Economics means theories, what we study in books. Theories which are given by various thinkers, scholars with respect to market, employment, money generation, etc. So when they give theories, we implement these theories in our economy, which is a real picture of economics. So this is a very minute difference between economics and economy. Okay, so we'll move further. So the next topic which we are going to understand, that is the evolution of economics as a separate subject. Previously, to give you a timeline, generally 300 to 400 BC, in that era, economics was not dealt as a separate subject, whereas it was part of section philosophy. You might be knowing various philosophers such as Aristotle, Chanakya, Xenophon. Chanakya's Arthashastra will be a very renowned book which you might be knowing. Aristotle was a Greek philosopher, but these philosophers gave various economic theories. So economic was not dealt as a separate subject in that period, whereas it was the part of philosophy section. But economics as a separate subject evolved in a later part, somewhere around in 19th century, where Adam Smith, Lionel Robbins, Marshall, these people, they gave theories specifically related to economy. We'll be understanding about the theories given by these thinkers in the later half of this session. But before, let's understand from where this word economics come from. This word came from a Greek word, oikonomia, meaning household management. Household management, as you might be thinking, don't have the narrow interpretation. You can think it out of the box, like any closed entity can be called as house. You are staying at a place surrounded by four walls, you can call it as a house. You are staying in India, guarded by all kind of men and women, surrounded by all four sides, can be also called as a house. So it's a broader entity. No need to understand at a micro level, like house, which means where you are staying or where people are staying, that management is economics. At a broader level also, economics is happening, which is called as a household management. Aristotle also stated that oikonomia means the science of household management. During 19th century, when economics evolved as a separate subject, during that period, Adam Smith, who is also called as father of economics, he gave a theory in his book Wealth of Nation, in which what he stated, Adam Smith, okay, and the essay which he wrote is called as Wealth of Nation, in which he stated how wealth is produced and how it will be used must be the subject matter of economics. So to give you example, let's assume that I have a business which manufactures some X entity. So how I am going to produce the wealth will be from this X manufacturing unit. Okay, and how I'm going to use this wealth? Suppose I'll buy capital, I'll provide salary to my workers, and those workers might go outside and they'll buy some daily essential goods, so that money will be flown somewhere else, right? So this will be the cycle which will generate in the economy. So how wealth will be produced and how it will be used must be the subject matter of economics. That's what he gave the definition for economics, alright, in his book Wealth of Nation. Later on, there is one more thinker, Alfred Marshall. Alfred Marshall stated that economics does not study only the wealth generation, but it also studies the activities centering to the wealth generation. Now it was a bit ahead, but it have similar meaning to the Adam Smith's definition. But what does it mean? Activities concerning to the wealth generation, which means if suppose I have the X entity of manufacturing unit, but what activities I am doing, like suppose I need transportation, which means the service sector. Those activities also should be taken into consideration while concerning the wealth generation. So these two thinkers have more or less the same meaning of economics, where they are concentrating towards the wealth generation. Later on, Leonel Robbins, a modern economist, gave a bit appropriate theory, okay, or a bit appropriate definition for economics, in which he stated resources are scarce, but how do we use these resources to produce the valuable commodity will be the objective of economic study. It looks a bit fair, right? Because as you know, resources are always scarce, population is always increasing. So how do we use these resources to provide commodity to these unlimited population, right? You might be knowing also this Buddhist theory, in which is stated human desire is unlimited, right? But resources are scarce, right? So that's why in which the money comes as a medium of exchange, right? So that's why we call Leonel Robbins as a modern economist. Why? Because he gave a most appropriate definition which give a complete justice to economic studies. Alright, so now as you understood how this economics as a separate subject got evolved, now let's go to the second topic of introduction session, that is evolution of money. You know, from history, we have three forms of money, right? The first will be barter system, second will be coinage, and third will be the paper currency, which is the latest one, right? So first let's understand the barter system, and then we'll go ahead to coinage and then paper currency, the evolution of paper currency. All right. So from Harappan period, you might have studied in history, Harappan and various other civilizations, barter system was most prevalent method for transfer of goods. For the first time, barter system recorded in Egypt, Egyptian civilization, which is also called as Mesopotamian civilization. So there we have first evidence of barter system. As I told you last time, there were various thinkers and philosophers of Aristotle, Chanakya and Xenophon who gave economic theories, in which Aristotle's one theory which states that if the market exchange, which means if I want something, I need to exchange something with you, right? This is what is called as barter system. I'll give you one thing, you'll give me another thing in replacement of that particular entity, right? So Aristotle stated, if barter system is the market exchange, then people try to satisfy their natural needs. Getting the point? If barter system is the market exchange, then people try to satisfy their natural needs. Why? You need to understand one more concept to understand this statement, because barter system have double coincidence of want. Double coincidence of wants. Now what do you mean by this word, which is a very important thing, okay, which is one of the characteristic of barter system. Let's have an example to understand this double coincidence of want. Suppose I require wheat and I have rice in replacement for that particular wheat entity, right? So I need to find someone who require rice and also he have wheat in exchange of that. So this concept is called as double coincidence of want, which is a kind of coincidence, right? So that's the reason why we call it as a double coincidence of want. We need to satisfy this in a barter system. So now let's come back to the theory of Aristotle, which stated, if barter system is the market exchange, people try to satisfy their natural needs. So let's imagine the current scenario, where if you have money in your pocket, then you can buy anything. If you don't require, still you can buy, right? So you are not satisfying your natural need, right? You just have money, that's the reason why you are purchasing that particular commodity. So it's not your natural need, but if it would be a barter system, you might be satisfying your natural need and you won't be buying unnecessary commodity. In barter system, there were valuable commodities as well, like how we have currently gold, platinum, diamond. Likewise, there used to be cattle and wheat or grain, any type of grain, were valuable commodities during that period in barter system. Later on, we shifted to coinage. Somewhere around 600 BC, we recorded the first coinage or the first coin sample in Lydian's dynasty. Lydians is the Asia Minor, which means current Turkey, that Turkey area is used to call it as Asia Minor during that period. So this Lydians dynasty came out with the first gold coin in 600 BC, that is the Iron Age period. If you can study the history period, that is 1000 to 500 BC period is called as the Iron Age period, because the iron was developed in this era or in this period. So we call it as the Iron Age period. So this coinage was started from this Lydians. Later on, various other kingdoms adopted this method instead of barter system. And what we used to use as a coin, that is a gold, silver, which we also called as a precious metals. So we started using them later on, and we shifted to the coinage period after 600 BC. In history, in Indian history as well, like Gupta king, and later on Satvahanas and various other kingdoms have started using this coinage for the daily exchange for the commodities, where they used to use precious metals. Later on, we'll be shifting towards the paper currency, which is a bit important part because that's the thing what we are using at this moment as the medium of exchange. We'll be covering evolution of paper currency in our next session. So by that time, stay tuned. If you have any query, feel free to comment. You can also contact on my email ID, which is specified in the description section below. So thank you very much.